For years, I've been nervous about how my research would be viewed by those who actually work in the field of law enforcement or who actually deal with methamphetamine users or manufacturers in the real world. The Oklahoma Bureau of Narcotics and Dangerous Drugs played a very important role in helping me shape this project from the very beginning, whether it was directly or indirectly or purposefully or inadvertently. It started with a chance encounter. One of my colleagues who was housed in the office next to me, he was a former police officer with a PhD in philosophy. And I had mentioned to him that I was looking to find some data on methamphetamine and to learn more about the problem. And he said, well, I have a guy I went to PhD school with who's actually a chief drug agent at the Bureau of Narcotics. And that's really the meeting that started this project 10 plus years before the book ever, you know, came out and was published. And it was actually Dr. Duncan who helped to draft the Oklahoma House Bill 2176 that, you know, it was him who planted the seeds of this being such a big problem that we really didn't understand and that we needed to know more about and that, you know, needed to be studied. And I worried for years, I mean, really for the entire time that I was collecting data and analyzing data and then eventually writing up the research and working with the publishers to get it published, I actually in some way feared the law enforcement community. I would meet some of my colleagues who I have great respect for and who I'm indebted to in terms of, you know, owing them a great deal of gratitude for teaching me about methamphetamine and meth labs over the course of years. And I remember meeting one of them at a conference one day, and he asked me how the book was going. And when I told him that it was going to come out in about a year or two, you know, he was very excited to read it. And of course, I conveyed to him that I was nervous that, you know, whether or not he would like it or agree with it or find it, you know, maybe wrong. I mean, my whole book is based on interviews with former users, dealers, and manufacturers. And there's always a, you know, hint of doubt at the back of your head that maybe you got it wrong, you know, especially when you have a sample size as small as 33. And to be honest with you, at the end of it, when the book finally came out, I was fortunate enough to be able to give the book to a few of the law enforcement officers and agents, and one's a former chief of police who had worked for almost two decades in a small town. And I was able to give them a copy of the book, and then I kind of waited. And I think for me, the turning point of feeling more confident about the work and its contribution to our understanding of methamphetamine and drugs and addiction and manufacturing came when I received feedback from these law enforcement officers. And the, you know, one of them sent me a text, and I could read you the text, and it's quite powerful. And one of them, you know, sent me an email right after he finished it and told me that it was a powerful book. And, you know, I still am having those. Those aren't necessarily posted anywhere, but I would like to share those at some point because those validated the project in a way that nothing else could. When you have somebody with 20 or 30 years of law enforcement experience who has actually responded firsthand to those involved with meth and or their manufacturing activities, read the work and say, you nailed it. You know that it worked. And I am thankful and grateful to those who helped me learn all that I needed to learn to get to this point, and then who, after the publication of the work, confirmed and validated that what had been produced was real, at least for some of those involved in the world of methamphetamine.